We're back again today with Marc Steinberg, who is the founder of Creative Consciousness. And we're continuing our series about stress and burnout. And particularly this week, we're talking about falling back into old patterns and old habits. So most of us know the first step is getting help, going to a training maybe, getting rest, listening to your body, looking after yourself. But what happens next?
Thank you, Jennifer, and hi, everyone. So, a burnout, a stress situation of a high level is always a signal from our life that we are needing to attend to key questions in our life. You know, usually we get so early busy in our lives, being completely part of a society lifestyle mechanism, that taking time to answer the questions that are really key for everyone's life is not attended to. Then burnout, you can also reframe it and call it a spiritual crisis. That is also not really so far off the truth, because it is forcing us to come back, getting centered by being not able any longer to have the motivation and energy to continue the way we plan to continue. We would like to continue from our ego that has a particular plan to go someplace. No, it's like put on hold. It's very awkward. It's frightening because we feel threatened in our survival. We feel threatened in making it in life. But all of that brings us inevitably back to key questions. Key questions, for example, what is it you're really here for? I mean, what's your soul's incarnation purpose? Yes, okay, we need to care for our lives. We have responsibilities. We do know joys of family life, of success, and these kind of things. But when you take time and go a little bit deeper, then you see that these are all external circumstances. And there's something far more bigger about life than the external achievements and the things that come and go. You know, you can't keep a car forever. You can't even be with people forever, although we would love to do that, sure. Yeah? And so what is it you're really here for? Who is it you are meant to be in the eyes of the divine? That is the question. And this is something what everyone needs one time or another to attend to and to answer. So burnout, depression, loss of motivation, loss of energy, illnesses that put us into a different reference frame where our plans, the way we get comfortably acquainted with a particular plan, they are destroyed. And it brings us to an opportunity, the opportunity to reconnect with the divine source, to reconnect with what is bigger than us, to reconnect with the essence in us. And yeah, so for me, that is the big opportunity here. And when you ask those questions, you may not find immediate answers. That's normal. But to be present to the question, to really focus your energy from away from the mourning that things are not continuing the way you wish they would, and redirect it to yourself, then you're going into the right direction. See, Buddha said, there is no way to happiness. Happiness is the way. Now, happiness for us human beings, we are so conditioned to have it completely externalized. Once we get the circumstances we want, happy. If we don't have them, not happy. That is too cheap for life. Life is much deeper. And happiness is the way means to find the appreciation for life as is, to focus on what we have rather than what we don't have, to learn to appreciate and find joy in the little things, even in the pleasure of just being able to be alive. The purest happiness comes from the appreciation of something far bigger in us than the little ego, to be alive, to breathe, to have this opportunity. And even if your body is not in a good shape, there is behind the pains, behind the inabilities, behind the awkward emotional feelings and from the emotional body, behind that is an awareness, is a state of being that is untouchable, that never begins and never ends. And you can fall back in your awareness into this bigger you. And once you're there, you see that your life is dramatically changing, because then burnout is obsolete. You got the message. There's a purpose behind every tragedy that happens to people in life. It is bringing us by force back to what we have been missing, serving our ego's desires too much and in a state of unconsciousness. So letting go of the secondhand dreams and idols, ideals that we have adopted from society, from the magazines. We want to show off who we are, compete to others, drive our cars where we feel better than the rest of the world. I mean, all of that is really superficial, and it's not lasting. Our whole world is in a spin towards the next level of evolution, towards a more conscious, a more holistically congruent world. And the old patterns, the old models of how we live our lives are breaking down. We see it in all areas of our lives. And it is by force us getting into a sanity where we consider the real purpose of life. And that's not about making money. That's not about having all the things in place. It is going into the spiritual values. And that's not airy-fairy, no. Some can learn it by cooperation and others can learn it through being forced. But everybody who has experienced burnout, or when the stress hormones flushing through your body and when the overdose of adrenaline and cortisol and all of that is putting your body in such a stressful situation that it needs a big break and collapses in a burnout, into a depression, well, then people are usually very receptive to redirect their attention. But does it need to get that far with you? So I hope that you can see that there is a calling individually, collectively, globally, for all of us. And the sooner you are considering the calling and starting to re-examine your values in life, what's important and what's not important, the less you become subject of being redirected with your attention by force to answer those questions.
Yeah, so we're going to learn it one way or the other. So we can either cooperate or we can learn the hard way as usual.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. And what struck me there is it's like we're filling our life with stuff to cover up. Yes. To cover up what we don't want to look at. And we're afraid of that idea of nothing.
Yeah.
That you mentioned there, that when we get to that point that we're forced to drop it all and be with nothing. And that's very scary for a lot of people.
It is scary. We try to escape from the feeling of loneliness, from emptiness, from nothingness. And anything is better than that. And I understand that. I mean, who wants to feel lonely? Who wants to feel empty? Who wants to feel nothing? On the other hand, we experience consistently that what we are holding on to, what gives us something, what fills us up with something, that this attachment will cause us suffering, because anything I hold on to inevitably comes with a price tag called fear. Fear of losing it. And that fear is building. And that fear is always the womb for more fears. And then we have more attachments and we get more and more stressed out with securing our turf, in not in order to lose that what we think gives us fulfillment. But it's an illusion in the first place. So the concept of security that we have been conditioned to believe is a false concept, because that security, what society made us believe, is all external. And we became a slave to secure our lives on an external level, only to experience that no matter how much money you have in the bank account, the next financial crisis may take it all away. The banks may be collapsed, the currencies may be collapsed, and then what? In the body, it's the same thing. Yeah, we have not much control over external circumstances. We never know. So the only security really that does exist is internal. And internal security means that you are being fully present in the moment, that you learn the art to be in the moment, because the moment always is. No matter where you are, no matter what condition you're in, there is always the present moment. It's an art what we need to relearn, because we have been dragged into going into the past and projecting into the future. That is a way of life not really sustainable, and certainly not a way of happiness. To be in an open heart, to open your heart, to learn, to reconnect to the heart space, so that we can feel life, that we can feel a plant, that we can feel a tree. Sounds crazy? No, absolutely not. That's what people expect when they do psychedelics, mushrooms, and all kind of other drugs. Yeah, or that's what people get when they go into the mountains. Yeah, they breathe, they want to stand there on the summit and get this injection of nature, and to learn to enjoy and feed from what is free available, what we do not have to protect, what we do not have to make our own. Yeah, a great walk. How much more joyful can life possibly get? And then your appreciation, your awareness, and your unconditional love, that's all internal. And that means you have access to it 24/7 by simply choosing to attend to that. As I just mentioned, it's a choice to choose to attend to what you have and take your attention away from what you don't have. The ego always is dwelling on what you don't have, because it wants you to go for the next thing it can identify with. So we follow the carrot of the ego all the time, never reaching the point of stillness, the point of coming home, the point of joy. And all of that is something we need to learn. And when we get that there's little we control externally, we can take a deep breath and we can give life a chance to show us the way. But for that, we need to reduce manipulating life the way we think we want it, because that's what everybody is doing. That's why we have competition. That's why we have the elbow mentality in society. That's why the gap between poor and rich, between all of that mess, comes only from having lost the pure purpose of life, having lost the meaning of life. And yeah, we see what's happening, and I hope it's not going to get worse. But what if it does? It still means that everybody is going to retreat to one's own state of awareness, and we become sane by force. And I wish it would be, there would be another way, but look around, look at the world, what's going on. I'm an optimist by nature. However, I'm not blind. So when we see all the stuff that is happening, we know, everybody knows, deep down, we are on the wrong track. Yeah, this direction we're going is not good. No, it's not. And you hear it from all sides. So start for yourself. You can't expect the world getting better tomorrow, so you get better. As in directing your attention and your plans and everything to where you are invincible, and that is in your inner state. Your awareness cannot be destroyed by nothing. Not even death can destroy your awareness. And awareness of self, self-acceptance, enjoying to be alive, feeling the goodness in you, opening your heart, that is bringing you joy. And when there's joy, then you don't need anything else. It sounds simple. It is simple. And we need to really recondition ourselves and detach from the false values we all bought in.
Yeah. Yeah, it is true. Society is crazy right now. Our lifestyles are crazy. The modern world, I think, is pushing us to the brink. And especially right now, things are very unsettling in the news, in the world, sure, with our health, finances, all of that.